The Maimorn Banshee, known as Lady Harrow, has been tasked by Almighty Nagash to hunt down intruders into the Mirrored City. In this video, we're going to show how to paint Lady Harrow, and we'll be painting her in the classic method and up to battle ready. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, we've used grey sear, which is perfect for the colours we're going to be using in this video. Now, we're going to start by painting the cloth, and for this, we'll be using iron rack skin. So I'm just going to give the pot a quick shake, pop that lid open, and I'm going to be using a medium base brush to apply this to start off with. So I'm just going to grab a little bit onto the palette, like so, a little bit more than that, and a little touch of water, just so it's not too thick and goopy, and then we're ready to start base coating. So all I'm going to do now is then just start applying that all over the robes. Now, if you can, just try and avoid that jaw on those arms, and if you do get any paint on it, just tidy back up with grey sear. And there we are, with the cloth now done, we're going to move on to painting the rest of the base coats. We're going to start with the basque or the corset, and for this we'll be using Catechan flesh. Any brass or gold details, we'll be using Balthazar gold. For the silvers, we'll be using iron hand steel. Then we're going to move on to painting the bits on the base. We'll start with the stonework, for that we'll be using Mechanica standard grey. For the vines, we'll be using Deathwood forest, and then we're going to finish off by painting the flowers or the roses by using Barrignar burgundy. But first of all, let's start with that corset. So I'm going to be using Catechan flesh here. I've got a medium layer brush as well. Just apply a little bit of water again, just so it's not too thick and goopy. Remember to get our brush to a nice point, and we're ready to start applying those base coats. So all we've got here actually on the Maimorn Banshees is just a little bit just around the corset there. So you might want to do a couple of thin coats, because some of that grey sear will start to show through. There's also a back area to do as well. With the corset now done, we're going to move on to painting all the gold details with Balthazar gold. So that's things like the hilt of the weapon, the pommel of the weapon, and also the hourglass just on the side there. Now it will vary from different models, so just check the box art if you're not sure. With the gold now done, we're going to paint the blade of the daggers, and for this we'll be using iron hand steel. With the silver on the dagger now done, we're going to move on to paint the stonework on the base, and for this we're using Mechanica standard grey. With the stonework now done, we're going to move on to painting the vines and the leaves, and for this we're using Deathwood forest. Just take your time, and if you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up any areas using Mechanica standard grey. With the vines now done, we're going to move on to painting the flowers or the roses, and for this we're using Barrignar burgundy. And when you've done that, any bone details, just re-base coat those if you've made any mistakes with grey sear. There we are, with the flowers now done, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to apply some shades. Now we're going to start by using Nylac Oxide thinned down with Lamy Medium. This is going to go on the robes, the arms and the jaw. After that, we're then going to use Nighthawk Gloom, also thinned down with Lamy Medium, which is just going to go on the dress. Then after that, we're going to use Agrax Earthshade for anything else that's not been coated. So first of all, let's start with that Nylac Oxide mix. So what I like to do is apply the Lamy Medium first. So I'm going to apply 3 paintbrushes worth of that, and then 1 paintbrush of Nylac Oxide, and I'm just going to mix that together. That'll give us a nice thin down mix. Once I've loaded my brush up enough, I'm then ready to start applying that to the model. So basically we're looking at anything that's been base coated with iron rack skin and also grey sear. So just coat this all over, and if it starts to pool at the bottom, just use your brush to soak it up. There we are, the robe's now done. We're going to be using Nighthorn Gloom thinned down with Lamy Medium, just like we've done the Nylac Oxide. We're just applying this to the dress. With the dress now dry, we're going to be using Agrax Earthshade to shade the remaining areas that have not yet been touched. So that's the corset, the knife, and of course the base. And when that's dry, don't forget to rim the base in a colour that matches your force. And for this one, we'll be using Steel Legion Drab. And there we are, with the rim of the base now painted, our Maimorn Banshee is battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paints, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always neat them back up with those base paints anyway. Secondly, when using shades, or as we did in this video, technical paints, try not to overload your brush, as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, it starts to pool in those recesses, just use your brush to soak up any excess. And lastly, when using Lamy Medium, it's always best to apply the Lamy Medium first to your palette and then your colour after, as you don't want to start contaminating those pots of Lamy Medium. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Maimorn Banshees, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.